Hola, people. This is about my fourth video on this Sunday afternoon. I just took, some of y'all know, I have done a few videos this morning doing some cooking and cleaning and ranting and talking to myself without talking to myself, talking to y'all. And I find it kind of therapeutic. I don't know why. But God forbid I actually watch myself. Like, I was talking to my bestie or whatever. Like I said, she's like my one viewer. she's like my number one fan, okay? She's my cheerleader. And she watches every time. She's the only person I know that watches my videos every time they come out. And she laughs and she cries and she just totally enjoys them. I don't know why, but she does. Anyway, I still have a ton to do. I have been moving on my own time because I am in a quiet, kid-free home right now. My kids are with their grandparents and aunts and uncles right now. And my husband is gone right now, so I am really chilling right now. So, long story short, I am taking a very slow day. I am taking my time. I have a pot roast in a crock pot right now that is pissing me off because it's been there since 11 and it's barely done anything. And I've had it on high. It is now 5 o'clock, right? 4:49. The shit ain't even simmering. I don't know what type of ghetto crock pot I have, but it is pain in the ass. It is from Walmart. That's what I get. Pain in the ass. So what I'm thinking, because it's damn near 5 o'clock, that damn pot roast is not going to be done until about 9, 10 o'clock, and I'm not eating that late. No, I will not. So, what I'm going to do, which is very frustrating, because the point of, and y'all mothers know, the point of having a damn crock pot, A, you ain't got to watch over it. It's supposed to do its own work, even though mine's ain't shit. B, you ain't got to wash a bunch of pots. I have been washing a bunch of pots for weeks now because I'm nonstop cooking. I didn't want to. One pot was fine. But this shit is so ghetto. I'm gonna show y'all. Watch. Hold on. And y'all excuse my hair. I don't, if you don't like realness, don't watch me. Baby, I am real, real, real. You gonna see the real. Okay, let me turn this shit around because this is, look at this. Barely even any steam. Look at this. Hold on. This shit will burn you. How you gonna burn? You ain't cooking nothing. Look at that. It ain't moving. It ain't moving. It's been cooking for about 5 hours. Close to 5 hours now. It's not moving. The veggies haven't done anything. It smells good. It ain't doing nothing. I need a new crock pot. I'm doing. And it pains me to do this. And I end up having to pour all this, transfer it from a crock pot to a baking dish. I don't have a lot of baking dishes. I have one I have in mind that I think will do good. If you know, I have most flat pans that I've inherited from my grandma-in-law, mama. But they're flat, they're sheet pans, and that's a roast with a lot of juice and a lot of veggies. So the deep dish that I do have, pray for me. Anyway, what I was saying is, I don't like seeing myself on TV or hearing myself talk. My voice get on my nerves. The fact that my lips, for some reason, I don't open my mouth when I talk. My lips stay like this. I don't know why I talk like that. I just don't know. But when I tell you it is authentic, it is real. What you see is what you get, boo. This is me. Me. There is too many imposters around acting like their life is perfect and all this other stuff. No, ma'am. If you got 8, 10, 12 kids and you don't look like this, and you doing it by yourself. I don't even give a damn if you got a husband. If you got that many damn kids, your husband is your second child, your number one child. Period. He needs shit too. Shit don't ever end. Anyway, so I started that. I cleaned the kitchen. Clean my kitchen. Look at my stove looking good and junk. I'm gonna clear out the few dishes in my sink. I did eat some breakfast. Well, it wasn't really breakfast because I just ate maybe an hour ago. My table is clean for the most part. I did not sweep, but it's not that bad. Anyway, honey, I still fix. Wait, what am I doing? Clear out the sink. Clear out the dishwasher. I need to, and I really don't want to. My oven. I made, cause, oh, look at that. Look at that. Look at that. To save a lot of time, to save a lot of headache, I use the oven a lot. I rely on my oven. Oh, shoot. I'm sorry, Molly Yay. I love her. Girl Meets Farm. That's my gal. I want to do a drive-by with her. You know, AK's out the window. I'm just kidding. She's just so freaking awesome. I love her. It's me, Molly Yee. Molly Yee. I say Yee, but it's pronounced Yay. But I feel like it needs to be Yee. And it's only because I'm a big girl. Okay. Anyway, let me. You know that beat from one of my favorite movies in the entire world, Silence of the Lambs, and that crazy psychopath and drag queen man. Doo-doo. That 80s beat. I'm an 80s baby, by the way, and I love everything 80s. That song's playing in my head right now. I don't know why. Do do. Do do. And he's doing his weird dance. Yeah. Anyway, you see how my brain goes? Everywhere. So, I have a shite ton of things to do. I still have to somehow get rid of this laundry. It's all clean. All of it's clean. My husband cleaned it. These are majority of our kids' clothes. I've been so tired, and I'm gonna be freaking honest with you. I've been keeping them in. It's sad. They have drawers, barely. But I just keep, I'm not gonna do that to y'all. I'm gonna go potty first. Hold on. Doo-doo. Sorry, I had to pee. Doo-doo-doo. And I didn't want to do that to y'all. I ain't got to be here in my river. I'm gonna take this. Oh, Lord Jesus, help me. It's a fire. Look at this. Ooh. Just stress, Lord Jesus. I ain't even got a letter. You know they got the 4C, BB, honey. I got a shape. This is like a faux triangle. It don't even have an... Lord have mercy. This is terrible. Terrible, terrible. 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 Anyway. Doo-doo. Doo-doo. Wrap this down. I can't even deal with it. But anyway, I need to wash, scrub the tub. I need to get it over with. I need to, and because I was laying up here, it took me like a, I would say about a 40-minute nap. Because I was still watching Girl Meets Farm, my cooking show. So it was about 40 minutes. Took a little nap. Little nap. And now I can't see where the hell my glasses are. I cannot see one of my glasses. I can't see Nathan. Hold on. Not where I normally put it. Oh no, I see something shiny. I think it's over here. Yep, found it. Found it. My kids, my kids are my eyes and my husband. They're my eyes. So, after I take my showers, baths, if I take my glasses off and I can't see nothing, they help me find it all the time. Anyway, so I need to clean the bathroom. I need to fold and put away these clothes. You know, even when your kids ain't here, you're still a mama. And I need to figure out what the hell I'm gonna do with this roast. That ain't cooking. That haven't cooked, even though it's been cooking for 5 hours. 4 at the least. Why you ain't simmering, boo? I done burnt my finger on the side of it and everything. You still ain't simmering. Anyway, so I gotta do that and that. I need to drink some water. Take my meds. Let me do that now. Stay right there. Baby! Baby! When they got ice, boo. My mother-in-law always tell me to drink warm water instead of cold water. But baby, I love my Mila. I love my Mila. I love her to death. Let me tell you. Well, to life, to live, to whatever they be saying. To life, to live, whatever, forever. Forever, ever. But the way this body run hot, I need my ice. Boo-boo. Oh, Lord Jesus, it's a fire.
cholesterol pill. I'm on cholesterol, I'm on diabetes. Take my medication, love.
Oh, no. We're gonna have to fix that.
Bing, bing. Bing. And yes, I'm a hoe for Lexapro. If you know, you know. This is the most refreshing thing in the world. Ice cold water. And where I live in the Bay, the tap water is pretty good. Be damn good. Anyway, okay, here we go. What should we do first? So what I've learned, what I'm gonna do now is 5:04. I started that damn roast at 11 something, and y'all seen the way it was looking. Now you supposed to be a slow cooker and all, but I have you on high, and you haven't bubbled. Not even one bubble. That's a problem. Okay, so anyway, and believe it or not, I'm really just recording what I do on a daily. This is just me, honey. This is me around the house talking. Normally talk to myself. People, my husband, I get on his damn nerve, but he get on my nerve too. He don't be wanting to talk. I'm just kidding. He do be wanting to talk, but not really. He do, but he don't. He do sometimes. Oh shit! I need to plug up this phone so I can do this. I was trying to go live so it would make my life easier. But y'all can watch me do my little. Cleaning this damn bathtub. You see this? I don't tolerate. No, ma'am. No, ma'am. Soap scum. I don't play that shit. Nope. Soap scum. Nope. Mm-mm. Eh-eh. Nope. Look at this. Nope. No ham and no turkey. I don't do it. What I'm gonna do... I'm gonna go ahead and put you here. Do do and pray. I have a tiny little ledge on this. Let's see how I can do this. I got a tiny little ledge. Can I do it like this? Can I do it like this, baby? Do do. Do do. Do. Why is that song in my head? Doo-doo. Maybe, hold on, y'all. I just put my charger in, so I'm just trying to see what has a better angle. Oh, shit. Don't break my phone now. Let me put it a little more stable now. Let's see. No, don't slip. Don't slip the ship. Again, honey, I am not no professional vlogger by no means. By any means, and you are blurry. Why are you blurry, boo? There we go. Do 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 do. See, y'all really just getting the counter. You ain't even getting the dang shower. I can't put you in there. Do do do. All right, so. Fixing this curtain. I love this curtain so much. I got it off Amazon years and years and years and years ago. It's so cute, colorful. This ain't working. This pissed me off. My phone don't like it. My phone don't like it. Okay. I'm trying to give my phone some juice. Hold on. And see, it's 21%. See, I can't be messing around now. And with it being on the charger, it's like I can't
right now. It's like this. And I can't go like this because it was getting blurry. Because I have it upside down. The camera keeps going blurry. And I have it on this little ledge that I do not trust. Alright, let's see. Come on, baby, now. Come on. Stay on. Stay on for mama. Okay. Y'all ignore my flapjacks, as my bestie calls them. Butter beans. They do look like butter beans now. All right, anyway. Baby, please don't fall. Baby, didn't I put a skosh? I think I put some in here. And what I've been also doing, guys, that I've learned from watching my other vlog, the YouTubers that clean and organize. What is her name? I love her so much. Oh my God, what is her name? Her face is, whatever. I'll get her name. This is called Mommy Brain. Okay. You take... Oh, wait. Okay, you see the toilet, right? Okay. You put some cleanser in there. I've also learned, so every time it flushes, it flush cleaning water. Get me? Or I've also have learned, if you put fabric softener, which I have, oh, son of a biscuit eating bulldog. Dang it! This closet kills me every time. Seriously? Seriously. Get back there. Ignite. Just ignite. Ding, ding. I don't know if this is fabric softener, but this is just extra game, you know, game be doing this thing. Honey, put that in that reservoir. Okay, you know that shit hella concentrated, and this is really, it's not fabric softener, but I've heard of fabric softener, but I do have this Gain detergent that smells absolutely amazing. I'm gonna put that in the bowl, in a thing. I'm gonna also add a little of the pinealin, a skosh. Like that. Maybe some down this drain, because these kids, honey, when after every meal, especially with Ezra, the toddlers, every meal, they be having hair in food and they hair up their nose everywhere. So when I put them in the sink and wash them, my strict rule is wash they behind like you almost bathing them. Okay, face, I'll be putting water in their face, boo. Soap, you gotta wash their hair out of the sink. And that's just after dinner. It's terrible. So, the things be going down this sink is not just some hand water. Just letting you know that. Anyway, so that's my one trick. So when you flush... Look, see? And that's just wear and tear. That ain't no shit on my toilet seat. Because I don't play that shit either. Honey, that's just wear and tear. But if you... Oh my gosh, it smells so good! And ta-da! Your toilet smells... Again, I have like a phobia thing with dirty toilets and bathtubs. No. That's where I draw the line. I cannot. Okay, so my other hack that I do when it comes to bathtubs, and I'm a strong believer, dish soap. Look at this. What does it say here? 2x grease fighting power. That is not just for food, boo. This shit right here, it works. It really cleans bathtubs. Really, really good. It really, really do its jobs. Doo-doo. I just checked my crock pot. Why is trying to bubble? Like, literally two bubbles. Like, if you don't get your ignorant. Okay, so y'all can't see. I don't know if you can. So y'all see the before. Now watch this be shining after. I'm gonna pull up my and mind you, we've been in this apartment for over 4 years. So the the tub is peeling. My mat covers up a lot of the peeling. But for 4 years, some people's tubs be busted, Like I said, I don't play that. This little contraption up here is the coolest toy. Do you pour water in here? Let me show you. That's a damn shame when this shit excites me. Wait, hold on. Let me hold it. Because there's holes in the bottom. Whoever the hell thought of that? Now watch this. See? The kids go bonkers. I know. They got holes in the bottom of this. I don't know why. Ignorant. Probably a man did it. Look at this shit. So cool. It's so freaking cool. What did they do with the damn holder? These damn kids. Here it is. Bam, bam. Bing. I want to get more of these. Because the kids just love it. And I pull it down and they just playing it. Play, play, play. Play, play, play. And I got my little fishies up here. Dory. Dory. Alright, here we go. Let's turn you off. Bing, bing. Bing. Let's put you here. Here we go. Here we go. If you know, you know. Can you see me? Not really, but that's okay. We gonna make it work today. Oh, Lord. I don't know what this weird scum. I don't know if it's concrete. I don't know what this is. Bothers the hell out of me. Alright, so I get my sponge that don't do shit. It ain't got no scrubber. I really want a scrub daddy. They call them scrub daddies. Got a little face on, a little happy face. I keep seeing and all the great cleaning vloggers, YouTubers, these incredible cleaners. Well, they're not cleaners, but they're, moms and junk. Do this shit. Bing. Let me take you with bing. Bing, bing. Let me get on my knees. Lord, pray for my sciatica. God damn it. All right, here we go. Bing. Bing. Now the soap is going to do the work. Okay. The soap is going to do the work. Now, let me turn this my hot water. When it wants to, it be hot watering, okay? Try not to wet my phone. Lord knows I can't afford another one. Can't afford the one I damn sure got. Okay, let's get out of here. Get this out of here. Let's clean this shit. Look at this shit. The bubbles, the damn dish soap do the work for you. This bullshit on my damn wall. I don't appreciate
Let me be honest with y'all. I'm gonna be real candid. Real candid. When I go to other people's house, yes, when I go to other people's house and use their bathroom, I scrub the toilet secretly before I use it. I don't care. I don't care. Well, I can be a chitch if my butt cheeks. See, this is 4 years. This is showing we've been here too goddamn long. We way past our visit, our stay. We way past it. Bing, bing. Look at this shit. Bing. All that peeling. Come on, toys. The kids got their basket. God damn it. Doing this shit with one hand for y'all. Do. This has been. Do. Now, honey, I would get real gangster if I didn't have any dish soap and be doing pure bleach. And my nanny, she hate that shit. She be like, F bleach. Bleach give you headaches. I know, but I love it so much. It hurts so good. Oh, okay. Do. Now watch this. Yeah, honey, I will scrub. When I tell you going to public bathrooms, and let me tell you something. I don't care where I've gone. And what kills me is, and I don't know if y'all got the same problem. When you go use a Starbucks bathroom, ain't they bathrooms nasty as shit? Look worse than a gas station bathroom. All the money these people make on a daily, and y'all can't afford a damn janitor or cleaning supplies? Y'all, man, disrespectful as hell. Every, every Starbucks I have gone to, their public bathroom is absolutely disgusting. And they trying to be bougie. Baby, well. Don't even get me started about Walmart. Oh, Target. Target's another one. Y'all making all this money charging people $10 for a biscuit. A can of damn biscuits. Don't make no damn sense. Yeah, y'all got deals sometimes. But y'all be trying to be bougie. And you can't keep your damn bathroom clean. You know. It's a damn shame when gas station bathrooms that you rarely find now. If you notice also, when you're out and about, you can't find a public bathroom that's open. Remember when you're able to go to the gas station bathrooms and you, oh no, it's locked, or we don't have it. We don't have a bathroom from customers. Why? You're a fucking pit stop. You guys are there for people's travel convenience. I don't understand. I just don't. I don't get that. They don't have bathrooms anymore. Then the bathrooms they do have is nasty as shit. Honey, I went to a park. Took the kids to the park, right? I ain't gonna show y'all this shit. Cause y'all don't wanna be seeing this type of shit. Cleaning the toilet right now. I'm the only person that cleans this damn toilet. Rinse. Anyway, went to a public park. I kid you not, it was the cleanest public bathroom that I have been to. in years. When I say a park got a better, a cleaner bathroom than a goddamn Starbucks, there is a problem in America today. I'm so mortified with bathrooms. Public bathrooms are atrocious. I mean, fucking, excuse my language. I'm really irritated, and I'm being an adult. I ain't got no kids around me. Amen. Okay, so I did the scrubbing, and now I'm going to rinse with some hot water. I'm going to put on this super stoker. Super soaker. There we go. Come on, baby. Baby. Clean, 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 clean. Get that. Get it, girl. Get it, girl. I am a clean freak. It might not even look like it, because my house don't ever stay clean. But that's not the way. That's why I say, I tell my husband and his three children, his three boys, every day, I don't live like this. I don't live like this. You disrespectful biatch. Get your ass up there. Messing up my damn cleaning rotation. Another thing I cannot stand. Loose hair. Baby. Maybe that's why I'm bald now. Shit. I don't know. I didn't curse myself. Who get pregnant and lose their hair and not gain their hair? Me. That's me. Every one of my goddamn pregnancies, the hair on my head fell out every fucking time. Every time. I said it would be me. It would be me. My nails would grow. They would break soon after, even though they were strong. But my nails would grow. I had hair grow in places I didn't want them to grow. Would grow. Expeditiously grow. Expeditiously grow. Grow. Grow, grow, grow. See, this diabetes, it's real. Woo! So I'm just letting it kind of rinse the bath pad and all that really good. Bing, bing. So look at this time. And look at this bullshit. Look at this. Look at this. Let's see if we got any bubbles, Ignite. Oh, look at that. Well, god dang it. Two bubbles. God dang it. There might be hope for you. And I noticed this. When it go over, that's when it'll pick up the heat. When it get past 5 hours. But why we gotta do all that? Like, I know you a slow cooker, but damn, you on a high. Anyway, yeah. Loose hair. If I find a loose hair in my sponge, I will throw it away. Even if I take it out. Even if it's one hair. I have a phobia. I don't know what. I've had lived in places where people didn't upkeep their bathrooms. And then I became a mother with toddler boys. Or boys, period. Being the only girl in the house. Where every one of them fails target practice. They target must be the wall, the floor, everywhere else but the damn toilet bowl. Okay, so now what I'm going to do is give the walls a good rinsing. What I really need is a detachable head, shower head. And you know, every time you hear that,
people go, they mind going to gutter and shit. You know, boo. No. First of all, I'm a plus size baby. I live on a plus size planet. And honey, we got curves and we got crevices that need gotten. Okay? And I'm big on, hold on. See, watch, look, ain't there some shit? This excites me. Cocktails used to excite me. This shit excites me. Why? Why am I this way? Why am I like this? They say, I don't know. It's ridiculous. Okay, anyway. So I've lived in situations where the upkeep of the bathroom was not upkeeping. And I mean terrible, terrible, terrible. And I would, before I did anything, scrub that mofo down. And I was not living by myself. I would scrub it down before using it. See, I'm getting all the stuff I can't get with the thing. And this crud, whatever the hell that is, I've scrubbed it, it will not come off. So I'm thinking it's like calcium, as they call it, and it's coming from the wall somewhere. I don't know. This shit's ghetto. I hate it here. But yeah, so loose hair. If I find it anywhere, like, I get so angry. Even if it's mine. I get so angry. And literally, my skin crawls. Let me go a little bit. I don't want it all over my damn floor. Even though I got it on my damn floor. Damn it. Oh, it just, Lord, it makes my whole skin crawl. I cannot stand it. Oh, and don't let me find, see, like this type of shit right here. Get off. It's the devil's goddamn piss. That's what it is. The devil's piss. I don't like loose hair and I don't like owls. Can't stand them. They flying demons. I don't give a damn what y'all say. They flying demons. Them things is ugly as shit. Scary as hell. Them vultures, Them motherfuckers got, they legs look like fucking sweatpants. Have you ever looked at a vulture's leg? That shit's suspect as hell. Why you born with sweatpants? No. Walking around with thin neck. Just disgusting. Disgusting. I cannot. My husband said I have a bird phobia. I don't know, because certain birds I adore. I want a damn parakeet. I want a parakeet. Like yesterday, when I was growing up, I had a macaw. It was my grandmother's bird, but she was my baby. And she would scream my name, Asia! 24/7. She would scream my name. She knew how to open my bedroom door. She didn't like it when I had company, because she thought they were trying to harm me. So she would walk off her cage and scare the shit out of my friends. I didn't have many friends. I was a loner. Still a damn loner. And I like it! I didn't like it then. But I like it now! For a good goddamn reason. People get on my freaking nerves. Alright, anyway. Seeing on my toilet. Okay, now I'm tired of the shower running and me wasting water. Because that's just money through my damn faucet. Alright, so. I know the water bill, they about tired of my ass. ass.
Here we go.
What was I talking about? I went from birds to cleaning. Yeah, my phobias. I can't stand owls. I can't stand big ass birds. Them damn ostriches. Ironically, I'm kind of shaped like one. Big at the top, little limbs, big in the middle. That's what I should say. I'm short. They tall in the middle. I'm short. Ain't got no booty. But all back, that shit pissed me off. I gain weight in my back. Who the fuck does that? Who does that? Like, really? Gain weight in your damn stomach like regular people. Regular damn people. Why you gonna gain weight in your back and not even in your ass? Your back? I don't understand. Like, it's like you can't even gain weight right. Like, shit. God damn it. And people need to also be aware. Let me spark this conversation, because it be in my head and I ain't got a lot of people I can vibe and talk with around me on a daily basis. Let me have this plus size talk with you, boo. Because, baby, now they trying to say curves is in, curves is in, curves is in. Okay. So, curves are in. They've always really been in. Every person likes the shape of a curvy woman. Okay. However, to be real and raw, plus size curves doesn't necessarily mean the curves are in the hips, in the booty. There are people be glorifying, and now I'm noticing everybody glorifying, of course, the small waist, the big hips, the big booty, big legs, big all that. And that's fine. And y'all glorifying plus size, I'm very happy about that. And you're starting to cater to us plus size girls, gals. But even in that, y'all don't think about us top heavy girls. Y'all don't. You know. We still out here struggling every day. Every day. I'm plus size. But look at how small my tongue is. Let that sink in. Look at how small my wrists are. Okay? Look at that shit. Bone. Okay? My arm ain't that big either. Look at this shit. Tendon. You can see my tendon. Don't get me started about these legs, honey. Let me show you. Look at this. Look at this shit. Look. This is my thigh, y'all. This is my thigh. My 4-year-old's thigh is double this size. Okay? Look at this. You can snap me like a chicken. Okay? But I still got the diabetes, boo. Okay? My back is backing. It's backing every day. My curve is a blur in my damn stomach. Okay? And I used to, okay, always been top heavy. Always, always, always. You know, we're here too. We're here too. We need love too. Okay? A man can have an ass, but he can't have breasts unless they're augmented. Okay? My toddler has an ass better than mine, and he's a boy. Actually, my toddler and my middle child, they got, and then these are my babies. They got more ass than their mama. Okay? I'm just being real. Distinguish a woman by her ass.
baby. Homegrown.
Homegrown, baby. In the genetics, boo. From my mammy to my grammy to Tess. Okay? We are here too. We need love too. Okay? Our stomachs don't go like this. Our stomachs go like this. SpongeBob. Okay? I've had 3 kids. My middle child was 10 pounds. My other child, my last child, he was born early. They got him out early. You know why? Because he was weighing so big in my stomach. They got him out early. Not even the same month as his due date. And do you know that boy was born over 9 pounds?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
When I was pregnant with my middle child and my third child, everybody thought I was having twins. I had, and every pregnancy, I lost more and more weight in my legs. My legs and thighs went by. I used to, that's one thing I had. Honey, I had legs. I can say that. I even to the point where my calves, when I would buy boots, because I love boots. I wasn't really a pump person, because I'm too damn clumsy, but I would rock a goddamn boot in a minute. The thigh-high boots, boo, I would rock it. Honey, but I used to have the problem where the boot, that part wouldn't, the fuck was that? The fucking gnat? Don't start that gnat bullshit. I dealt with gnats for 6 months. Anyway. You son of a... Get your ass. And how they melt into the air and shit. Like, you, I was seeing you with my eyes. And I go to hit you and you go away. Where did you go? You melt into the atmosphere. Anyway, so the calf part in the boot, one time my brother, I was window shopping with my brother, going shopping, because he was the clothes buff, Virgo man. He's the damn clothes man. Stayed up with all the fashion, blah, blah, blah. And I was his nerdy sister that wore my grandmother's shoes. And he hated it. Anyway, I tried on some boots, boo, and I couldn't zip it because my calves were too big and muscular. I didn't have no flab. My mom used to say, "Girl, you all jam and no jelly." Sure did. She sure did. That shit ain't cute. That shit is not cute. But here we are, okay? Here we are. This is what I got. And see, we don't have this conversation. You know? What about us? What about us? We are not in the curvy. We need to have our own freaking name. Because we are not in the curvy thing. No, we're not. No, we're not. Because that's not the curves they're referring to. Okay? That's not. You got 90-pound broads now having an ass of a 200-pound real woman. Okay? That's not normal. But those are the curves they talking about all the damn time. That's all they talk about. That's all they praise. You know, if you rocking the small waist and the big hips. Honey, I don't have hips. Okay? My hips. I don't have hips. I don't have none of that shit. I ain't got no ass. And that's bottom line. I ain't. Now, the older I got and the less active, my little ass look like a little tiny, you know, they jiggle a little bit now, but it's really skin. That's really what it is. His skin. Well, let's just get within, because the little cheeks is skin. Okay. But you see this shit? This is the curves we got. It ain't down there. It's up here. Up here. Okay. I call it fat back taffy. Fat back taffy. That's what I call it. When you have big breasts, as I do, the Lord wants to, and that's probably why. That's why I gain weight in my back. That's why. Because the Lord is trying to even out what's going on here. Okay? That's what's happening. But I've always had the tit-tots. Couldn't wear the cute little shirts. All the shirt, any t-shirt I wore, and I'm surprised I'm wearing this t-shirt's actually surprisingly comfortable. I don't like shirts. T-shirts, like regular t-shirts like this, I hate the shit. I hate it. And I'm going to tell you why. It is the big titty girl's nightmare. It is horrible. It is not comfortable at all. When people be making shirts and shit for the funerals and shit, these titties be so damn squished and uncomfortable and unruly. And just, what is that word? Offended? I got this damn, see this, why the damn thing is on. I don't even got it on a damn charger. Hold on. It's 16%. Girl, I've been vlogging for 56 minutes at this point. Why does man leave this irritating ass fucking watch every time? I hate this watch. I hate it. Let me show you this piece of shit. There it is. There it is. I hate this damn watch. Shut up. That's so damn random. Look at Lolita. She on my screen. These kids is here with me when they ain't with me. And this damn closet, our only linen closet, is ain't nothing but some demons trying to attack me. Open that damn thing. This shit start crashing down on my head. Anyway, but yeah, we don't have this conversation about us big chested girls. No, we are not the curvy. No, we're not. Shit. There's another goddamn gnat. Got you this time, you sons of a motherfucker. Got me cursing on this here Sunday. Oy. And this poopery is really good. My mother-in-law, she hit me to it. And then another thing I'm about to be mad at. Y'all charging these little fabric fresheners, and this shit ain't cheap. This shit is name brand. This shit is not cheap. Let me tell you something. The first day my husband bought this shit, still full. The first day my husband bought this, I tried to spray it. It wouldn't spray. Twisted the thing. The whole goddamn, no. That's not what happened. I was spraying. Okay, it wasn't locked. I was pushing the thing. The whole fucking thing popped off. There was a top on top of this. Popped off, broke immediately. Febreze, I noticed they punk ass brand, and I'm a Febreze freaking. Every time I buy a Febreze, their bottles are horrible. They break every time. And if it was me doing it, I would tell you it was me doing it. But it ain't freaking me. Okay, you see that little sparkle? Come on, baby. Sparkle in your eye. Yes. You better sparkle. Yes, tub. Yes. That makes damn indigestion. I drank water. Why is there acid reflux from water? Ice water. Ignite. Damn it. Jeez. All right, so I'm tired of cleaning. I don't want to be in here anymore. I'm out of here. I'm out of the bathroom. Peace, Duchess. All right. I see the sparkle in your eyes. Come on, wait a minute. Cameo. Alexa, play Sparkle by Cameo. See this bitch right here. She don't listen to shit I say. You better play the. Y'all heard what I just asked for. Let's see if she did it. She did. She don't listen to me. She listens to my husband, though. She a homewrecker. I don't like that. Alexa, turn volume to 5. How you gonna play a song and not have the volume? Alexa, turn the volume to 6. Now, listen. I don't own a copyright. Don't shut my damn video down, okay? So, what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna go in this little ass, dirty ass bathroom in my room. Let me tell you, I clean this bathroom every freaking day. It is tiny. Do you see how small? It's small. It's a half bath, okay? Very small, okay? This bathroom is always freaking dirty, and I keep my kids up out of it for the most part. They ain't allowed in here. No. Because they leave piss in my toilet every day. Keep that ignorant shit away from me. I don't even like my husband. He don't even really, like, he'll use it in the morning, but he don't really use, this is really my bathroom. This is my bathroom. But I clean this little motherfucker every damn day. And there's always some dust, some lint, like some, it is always. In your So I'm gonna do the same thing I did in there. I got this shit. You can't fucking smell it. Oh, oh! That's what I get for talking shit. And for some reason, and it just started like this year, my sink, I can clean it all I want. Has this residue. Like something's going on. Like if, look. Y'all see it? And like, if I do my makeup, it sticks. It sticks. It's never done that before. I don't know if the material's rubbing off in here. I don't know. But it's weird. I can soak it in bleach. It will stick. Oh, shit. Stay there. Just be normal. Oh, God damn it. I'm trying to cold y'all up now. Here we go. I don't do bath bombs, but they cute. I don't do bath bombs because it hurt my poo-poo. I don't care if they lay. Olay. I got a sensitive poo-cow. That's why all these babies came out the bum. Spot in your eyes. Baby. Yeah. Baby. I'd be afraid like the lid is gonna fall on my foot. That's why my brother called me Chicken Little. Here we go. Honey, you can get this shit is at the Dollar Tree, the 99-cent store. Stay up there. And got the poopery. If you know, you know. It worked, man. It worked. It worked good. Because I don't like smells. I don't like smells and I don't like residue. You know, people be leaving shit residue in the toilet. I don't like that. That shit is disrespectful as hell. I know you look at that bowl. Ain't nobody want to see that. Ain't nobody got time for that. They don't. I'm going to just spray this down. I got this Clorox. See, I keep it by the toilet. I don't even put it in the sink. Because I don't play that.
I clean. Let me stop talking while I'm spraying. That shit got on my tongue. I felt a little sprinkle on my tongue. Do you remember? The 21st night of September. Remember? It's hot as shit outside. My husband's like, it's only 80 degrees. Nigga, that's hell for me. Okay? Honey, I burn up in 60 degrees. Okay? This shit ain't cool. The fuck is trying to get me to move to Vegas? Are you? Man. I walk in that place and literally, like Dracula in the sun. That's going to be my last motherfucking headache. Bay Area heat fucks me up. The hell am I gonna do in the desert? Oh, this sponge is old and it's giving me the heebie-jeebies. What is that? Why is it hard? Something hard in there. I don't want you. Y'all, I'm gonna have to get me another sponge because that shit goes to the alcohol. Y'all, ASMR, whatever the hell that spell out, ASMRT, people that like to see you doing this, there you go, like to hear it, here you go, well, down, and I sleep out.